In this video, we will cover the cross-track advanced tuning step. In this step, we are tuning the valve responsiveness to cross-track error, or in other words, how far off the line the vehicle is. Our objective is to make sure the valve is quick to respond to offline changes, while also staying on the AB line without any oscillations. Remember the relationship between crosstrack and heading. A setting change will adjust the volume at which crosstrack talks to heading. To gauge performance, we will be using the guidance line with the tuning graph and the vehicle's response. A steer left or right command will move the vehicle to a new AB line approximately 4 inches left or right, and center wheels steers the vehicle to the current AB line. Start by directing the vehicle on the current AB line. To begin, first tap center wheels, traveling at your desired speed, then tap left or right. The gray line on the graph will move left or right, and the blue line will follow it. Now, gauge the responsiveness of the blue line. For cross-track tuning, it works best to now repeat the center command, then the opposite steering command. For example, in this video, our steering commands are center, left, center, right, center. This pattern can be continued as needed to help gauge performance. Since crosstrack is adjusted after steering and heading, tuning is not typically required. Performance differences may also be difficult to view in the tuning graph and the steered wheels. A high setting will have a fast response from the blue line and may overshoot the gray line. Continued oscillations may also occur. A low setting will have a lazy response from the blue line and be slow to reach the gray line. An ideal setting will have a fast response from the blue line with minimal or no oscillations. The blue line may overshoot the gray line, but should quickly correct itself and follow the general direction of the gray line. It is also very helpful to view the steered wheels and steering linkage while tuning. However, compared to previous tuning steps, with cross-track, it may be more difficult to differentiate steering reactions in real time. Using the same steering commands we just performed, ideal performance should be one or two quick reactions from the steered wheels before acquiring the AB line. Make sure the wheels are not too slow to react or are making numerous adjustments before acquiring the AB line. Repeat any steering commands as needed while adjusting the cross-track value until ideal performance is achieved. A good rule of thumb for cross-track tuning is to set the high value as high as possible without any oscillations in the steered wheels or excessive wandering over the guidance line. This completes the cross-track tuning step.